All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dan Blondal. He is the CEO of Nano One. And Dan, it's great to have you back. First time we've talked in 2022. So happy new year, my friend.
Yeah, happy new year to you as well. Great to be back.
So you and I talked before Christmas about an engineering study that you were commissioning, an independent study by a company called Hatch. What was their mandate? What were they looking at?
So we brought them on board to help us define what a full-scale automotive-scale cathode plant would look like in terms of its CapEx, in terms of its operating costs. So they really helped us define what the major pieces of equipment were, everything, all gets hooked up and how it's run. And then at the same time, we were comparing that to, this would be using our technology, and at the same time, we were comparing that to the incumbent process. So this is a process that's been building over the last 20, 30 years in terms of how cathode materials are made today. So it was really effectively a cost comparison between a really well-established, well-refined technology and Nano One really as an emerging technology.
And Dan, from the report, there was super positives on the cost side, and there's also positives on the environmental side as well. It really hit both sides of what you were looking at.
Yeah. So on the cost side, one of the things that was a great kind of outcome for us here is that we show ourselves being cost competitive on the CapEx in terms of building the plant, and also on the OpEx side, which is running the plant. And this is Nano One's process as it stands today, without the benefit of having the same sort of 20 to 30 years of optimization that the incumbent processes have. So there's a lot of blue sky and upside here still remaining in our process. And that's the kind of thing that, you know, our automotive partners are looking for in any kind of technology adoption.
Yeah. And less water, a lot of other things, like just on the environmental side as well.
Yeah, so on the environmental side, what's actually quite interesting, and it kind of got mentioned in the news release today, the incumbent process uses the input materials, nickel, manganese, and cobalt, in the form of sulfates, and that allows a certain chemical reaction to happen. All the sulfates come out in the form of a waste stream, sodium sulfate waste stream, and it's twice as large as the product stream. So you're making twice as much waste as you are product. And that starts to add up when you start to get into the millions or tens of millions of tons of this material that's needed to propel this kind of new, this whole new energy kind of revolution. And in order to meet those kind of volumes, we either are going to have to live with that waste, find some way to live with it, or we're going to have to eliminate it. And Nano One, we choose to try to eliminate it. And this report really helps highlight the magnitude of the problem that we're actually solving on the environmental waste side. And then on the water side as well, we use considerably less water in the process as well. So obviously, who's not to like that? That's a really kind of big upside on the environmental side.
Dan, just lastly, you picked on something I want to ask you about. You mentioned that the current process is, you know, 20, 30 years in the making, and this process is literally brand new. So I'm sure you get a lot of questions all the time, like, hey, when are you commercializing? Like, when are you going? But there really has to be sort of steps to understand to get to a point where you can get there quicker than 20 years, obviously, but you have to take certain steps to make sure that you're doing it the right way.
Yeah, look, you got to build up the supply chain. You've got to have the suppliers who can feed it. You have to be able to design a plant that everyone's got comfort level with. There's going to have to be capital expenditures into that plant and to build up the supply chain. So all of it is really about validation, comfort, de-risking. And so this is a very major step for us on the de-risking route to commercialization. And it certainly helps our partners better understand where we can take the technology. So while it isn't the final stage in commercialization, it's a very important one.
Absolutely. We'll leave it there. Thank you so much, Dan. Congratulations on this, very exciting times. And we look forward to talking again real soon.
Great. Well, thanks, Steve. Great to be here again.
All right. There's Dan Blondal, the CEO of Nano One.